Good morning, children. Hope all are fine. In today's botany class, we are going to study two topics, leaf type and leaf modification. So first, let's study about the leaf type. The pattern of division of a leaf into discrete components or segment is termed as the leaf type. So how the leaves are arranged in a plant, okay, how are the components of the leaf, they are arranged in a plant, that is called as the leaf type. Based on the number of segments here, maybe either one single leaf lamina may be present there or numerous small leaf laminas will be present there. That is called the segments here. So based on that, it is classified into two types, simple leaf and compound leaf. So leaf is said to be a simple when the petiole bears a single lamina. Lamina may be entire, undivided. Example, in mango leaf, or incised to any depth but not up to the midrib or petiole. Example, cucurbita. So here you can see this with the help of a diagram here. So there are, as I said you, there are two types of leaves, simple leaf, compound leaf. Simple leaf means on a petiole there is one single leaf lamina is present there. Okay, on a petiole one single entire leaf lamina is present there. This is called as the simple leaf. The simple leaf may have a margin which is entire without any incision is there. This is called as the entire leaf, as you can find in mango. Other one is there are some incision is there. This is called the incision. Okay, this incision, if it is not so deep enough, if it is not touching the midrib or the petiole, then it is also a simple leaf. Okay, so simple leaf is said to be a single lamina born on a petiole. This is the petiole. So on a petiole, only one single leaf lamina or leaf blade is present there. Then it is called as a simple leaf. So here in this, may be an entire leaf, or there may be incisions may be present there. If these incisions come and touch the midrib or the petiole, then we'll call it as a compound leaf. Okay, next we'll study about the compound leaf. A compound leaf means on a rachis. This is called the rachis. Okay, on the stem rachis are born, and on the rachis there are numerous small laminas are present there. That is called as the segments are present there. Laminas or leaf blades are present there. This is called as the leaflets. Okay, on a rachis numerous leaflets are present there. Then it is called as a compound leaf. So here we have studied that is a simple leaf and a compound leaf. In a simple leaf, on a petiole only one leaf lamina is present there. Then we call it as a simple leaf. And on a compound leaf, on a rachis there are numerous leaflets are present there. Then we call it as a compound leaf. Now here the difference, other difference between a simple leaf and a compound leaf, you can see as we have studied an axillary bud. Axillary bud will be present in the leaf base. So in the leaf base of the simple leaf only you can find an axillary bud. Similarly, in a compound leaf we can find the axillary bud will be present here, the base of the leaflets. Sorry, not at the base of the leaflets, at the base of the rachis you can find. Okay, so at the base of the leaflets we do not find any axillary buds. So this is the other difference between a simple leaf and a compound leaf. So here you can find the compound leaf is one in which the main rachis bears more than one lamina surface, that is called as the leaflets. Compound leaves have evolved to increase its total lamina surface. So the evolution, this evolution of compound leaves is what to increase the surface area of the lamina. There is one axillary bud in the axil of the whole compound leaf. That is, the axillary bud in the compound leaf is found at the base of the rachis. The leaflets, however, do not possess the axillary buds. No axillary buds are present at the base of the leaflets. Next, we are going to study about the types of compound leaves. So there are two types of compound leaf, pinnately compound leaf and palmately compound leaf. So first let's study about the pinnately compound leaf. A pinnately compound leaf is defined as one in which the rachis bears laterally a number of leaflets arranged alternatively or in an opposite manner. Already we have studied alternate and opposite manner in the phylotext. We have studied alternatively means in one node only one leaflet will be present there. Opposite we have studied in one node two leaves will be present in opposite direction. So as you can find in tamarind or you can find in cassia plant. So pinnately compound is what we have studied. That is, it is defined in which the rachis bears number of leaflets. So they are classified as unipinnate, bipinnate, tripinnate and decompound. Now unipinnate, the rachis is simple and unbranched which bears leaflets directly on its sides in alternate or opposite manner. Example, rose leaf. So here you can find this is the stem. On a stem a rachis is born and on the rachis numerous leaflets are present there. This is called as the unipinnate. Here also on the rachis you can find numerous leaflets are present there. This is called as the unipinnate leaves. Okay. Now based on the number of leaflets present on the rachis, it is called as paripinnate or it is also called another type is called as the imparipinnate. So there are two types of unipinnate leaves. So what is paripinnate? On a rachis, the number of leaflets, they are present in pairs. Okay, the number of leaflets, they are even and they are present in pairs, where it is called as paripinnate. This we can find in tamarind. In the neem leaf, you can find there is an odd number of leaf. Here it is paired, but on the tip you can find there is an odd number of leaf is present there. Then it is called as imparipinnate. So here we have studied unipinnate. Directly on the stem one rachis arise and on the rachis the numerous leaflets are arranged, then it is called as unipinnate. They are of two types. If the number of leaflets they are paired, if the leaflets they are paired here on the rachis, then we call it as unipinnate paripinnate type. On the rachis if the leaflets they are not paired and odd leaflet is present there, then it is called as unipinnate imparipinnate. Clear? Next you are going to study the next type of compound leaf, that is the bipinnate. The primary rachis produces secondary rachis which bear the leaflets. The secondary rachis, they are known as the pinna. The number of pinna varies depending on the species. So here you can find in bipinnate on the stem. So what will happen? The primary rachis arises and primary rachis further give rise to the secondary rachis, and on the secondary rachis the leaves are present there. This is called as bipinnate. Tripinnate, when the rachis branches thrice, the leaf is called as the tripinnate. That is, the secondary rachis produce the tertiary rachis which bear the leaflets. Example, moringa, that is the drumstick. Fourth type is the decompound. When the rachis of the leaf is branched several times, it is called as the decompound, as you can find in coriander leaves. So here you can understand this better here. Now unipinnate. So what you have said, this is the stem, the main axis of the stem. On this a rachis is born and the leaves are produced. This is unipinnate. Okay. Now bipinnate is what? On the stem, the rachis arises. This is the primary rachis. And from the primary rachis, it will give rise to the secondary rachis. And on the secondary rachis, the leaves are present there. Leaflets are present there. This is called as bipinnate. Tripinnate is what? This is the main stem. This is the primary rachis. This is the secondary rachis. This is the tertiary rachis. On the tertiary rachis, the leaflets are present there. This is called as the tripinnate. So here we have studied based on the compound leaves, they are classified as the pinnate types. So there are different types here. Study, four types are there. There is, if the only one rachis is present there and it bears the leaves, then it is called as unipinnate. If the rachis, the primary rachis, they further branch and produce the secondary rachis, and on the secondary rachis the leaflets are born, then it is called as bipinnate. Tripinnate means on the stem the primary rachis arises, primary rachis will give rise to secondary, and secondary give rise to the tertiary rachis, and the tertiary rachis they bear the leaflets, and it is called as tripinnate. more than this three ratchets, more ratchets are present there, then we call it as a decompound type. Next, you are going to study about the palmately compound leaves. A palmately compound leaf is defined as one in which the petiole bears terminally one or more leaflets. That is, on the petiole, there will be one or more leaflets will be present there, which seems to be radiating from a common point like fingers from the palm. This is called as the palmately compound leaves. Okay. Now, they are of different types. Unifoliate leaves. When a single leaflet is articulated into the petiole, is said to be a unifoliate. So, here you can find on a petiole, there is one leaflet is present there. Okay, now two lobes are present here. This is called as the unifoliate. You can find this in the citrus, lemon plant, you can find such type of leaves here. So, when a single leaflet is articulated to the petiole, so on a single petiole, two lobes or leaflets are present there. This is called as the unifoliate. Next, you can see here the bifoliate. When there are two leaflets articulated to the petiole, it is said to be bifoliate. Example, zornia. So, here you can find here on a petiole, two leaflets are arising. On a single petiole, two leaflets are arising. On the tip of the petiole, two leaflets are present there. This is called as bifoliate. Next is the trifoliate. There are three leaflets articulated to the petiole. It is said to be the trifoliate. Example, wood apple, that is Agil marmalos, clover leaf. So, here you can find on a petiole, three lobes are present there. This is called as the trifoliate. Next is the quadrifoliate. There are four leaflets articulated to the petiole. It is said to be quadrifoliate. Example, Paris quadrifolia or Marsilia. You can find here on a petiole, four lobes of leaves are present there. This is called as quadrifoliate. Quadri means four. Next, multifoliate or digitate. Five or more leaflets, digitate means finger-like. Five or more leaflets are joined and spread like fingers from the palm, as in Cleome pentaphylla or Bombax ceiba. So, here you can find on a petiole, there are numerous leaflets are arising. That is, from one petiole, tip of the petiole, numerous leaflets are arising. They are radiating like the fingers. Then it is called as multifoliate. Okay, children. So, this is what we have studied about the types of leaves. There are basically two types of leaves, simple leaves and compound leaves. And based on the now arrangement of the leaflets, they are classified into pinnately compound leaf and the palmately compound leaf.